Yesterday we were able to complete our chapter Happy Prince. Today we will be discussing question answer of the chapter The Happy Prince. We will discuss question answers. Ramanjit, I told you to keep your video on. I just want to see your face. Tell me. Yes, Ramanjit. Keep your video on. Yesterday you were doing annotation on my screen. Roll number 33, Ramanjit.
Yes, ma'am.
You were doing annotation yesterday on the screen?
No, ma'am, I was not.
Show me your face. Show me your face then. But their name was written on the screen because I have that option. With that option, I can see the persons who do annotations. You were writing something on the screen. Actually, there is a lot of technology. If you do such kind of silly things now, you are caught red-handed with proof. So next time, keep this thing in your mind. I don't want to waste my time. Let's do the discussion of question answers. So we have question number one, that is, why do the courtier call the prince the happy prince? Is he really happy? What does he see all around him? So you have to tell the courtier. Courtier means the persons who were in his kingdom. Am I audible? My voice is clear. My voice is clear. Am I audible? Only Simran is present in class. What about others? It is a matter of a proud for all of us that today Simran is going to interact with Kiran Bedi. That distinguished personality, Kiran Bedi, IPS officer, she is going to interact with that. I sent you a message in your class group, but nobody responded, only Nitish Maini responded and Simran. So she was asked to make a video of 30 seconds. She sent that video. She got it checked from me. And now she has been selected. She would be in that seminar and she would be interacting with that great personality. It is really a matter of proud for all of us. What about others? They should also participate in such kind of activities. These are the golden opportunities for you. Simran, wish you all the best. Give your best. You are going to represent your class. Okay. Simran, am I audible? Wish you all the best. Okay. Now let's do question answer discussion. Why do the courtiers call the prince the happy prince? Is he really happy? See, what was the reason? Why he was called happy prince? Because he always remained happy. Was there any reason to become sad in that palace? Why so? Because he was provided lots of facilities, comforts. His life was so comfortable. Switch on the lights. All the lights are on. I think there should be a switch. On. Sorry. That is off. Black one. Okay, now tell me. So, Dhiren, keep your camera on. Dhiren, show me your face. Okay, tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The courtiers called the prince the happy prince because the prince was always happy and delighted. Moreover, he didn't know what tears were. There was actually a different place, a different world in the palace, which always had a great atmosphere which made him happy. That's why he was famous as being called as the happy prince. But after his death, he was kept at a high place in the center of the city, and he saw all around the people's sadness, and he saw that his empire was not as happy as the prince was, and there was all types of things such as poverty and all types of people's misery in the empire.
Very good. See, because he was living in such kind of palace where sorrow was not allowed to enter. He was always happy, he always remained happy because all the comfort level was there, luxurious life was there, and he was not known to that fact that what were tears. He had a very comfortable life and he always remained happy. So these were the reasons that courtiers in the palace, they used to call him happy prince because he never became sad, he never cried in his life, okay. Even when he died, then his statue was made up high in the high on a raised platform. And what name was given to that statue? Happy. The same answer. Then you read. You tell. Wait. It's a lot of disturbance. Others keep yourself mute. Simran, you tell me this answer.
Yes. He was a prince when he was alive. Being a prince, he never knew sorrow and suffering. So the courtiers called him the happy prince. He never ever experienced all the misery and ugliness which the other normal living people used to in the city. But when he died, he was not happy in the real sense. Even when his heart was made of lead, he cannot choose but weep after seeing all the misery and ugliness of his city being on the top of the statue, and he was really sad, and from then he started shedding his first tears.
Yes, very good, perfect answer. The same answer I expect from Ramanjeet. Ramanjeet, you tell me same answer. What is your opinion? Why do the courtiers call the prince happy prince, and is he really happy? Tell me, Ramanjeet. Same answer. Now, Ramanjeet has left the class. I'm not able to find out. Okay. Ikjot, you tell me the same answer. Ikjot. Bache, be serious. Your exams are approaching. You should participate in class. You should be aware of this thing. I have given the answer. Two other students have also given the answer. Still, you are not able to frame. Ikjot. Really shame on you. Mitansh, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but
people called the prince happy prince. People called the prince as happy prince as he always made happy. But when he saw the darkness of the city, the tears came to his eyes.
Yes, afterwards. Jayati, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. The courtiers called the prince the happy prince because he lived in the palace where sorrow could not enter. However, the prince was actually not happy because he never got the chance to witness the misery of the people. By keeping himself away from sorrow, his heart never got a chance to feel the virtues of pity and sorrowness. So when his statue was placed at the point, he could see all the city laid before him and see their pain and hunger.
Very good. Very nice. Very well. Very nicely elaborated. So in this answer, we can write down, yes, the prince was called happy. Why so? Because when he was alive, he did not know the meaning of sadness. He had never experienced sadness and sorrow in his life. Okay. And he was living in a palace where sorrow was not allowed to enter. Okay. So when he died, he was made into a statue, and this statue was kept on a very tall column, and he was able to see the whole city. He could see the sorrow, misery, poverty, hunger, yes, hunger of the people in every in so many homes. So then tears started flowing out of his eyes, okay, to see the state of the city. And then he became sad very first time. Clear? Now let's move to question number second. Why does the happy prince send a rupee for the seamstress? What does the swallow do in the seamstress house? Seamstress is a female tailor. See, what was the condition of that seamstress? Very poor. She was busy in stitching gown, dress, and her son was also not keeping good health. He was suffering with fever. Okay. So what was the reason that Happy Prince sent a ruby? What was the reason behind that? So get ready with this answer. Nitish Maini, you tell me the second answer. Nitish. Yes, Nitish. Tell me second answer. Priti. No response. Vidhika, you tell me this answer. Vidhika.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, bachche, tell me this answer.
The happy prince sends a ruby for the seamstress because she was poor and her son was ill with fever. Her son asked her to give him oranges, but all she has is river water. The swallow was requested by the happy prince to visit and give the ruby to the seamstress. When the swallow reached her house, she was asleep and the little boy was tossing feverishly. The swallow kept the ruby on the table beside her thimble. He then gently went around the boy's bed, fanging the boy's forehead with his wings. The boy felt better and went into a deep sleep.
Good. Very nice. Your answer is perfect. You have well tried. Okay. Now, Renuka, you come here. Wait. Renuka, you come here and tell me this answer.
Asking his mother to for the oranges, but her mother was so poor that she can only give her son the river water. So the prince had pity on him and requested Swallow to pluck the ruby from his sword and gave to seamstress.
So she has given a very good answer. She has elaborated that story in a nice way, that what was the reason that Ruby was sent to seamstress. So Ikjot, you tell me same answer.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, please repeat the question.
Question here we have is, why does the happy prince send a ruby for the seamstress? What does the fellow do in the seamstress house? Start speaking.
Ma'am, please repeat the question.
Question is right in front of you. Second.
Ma'am, second one?
Yes, second is going in the class, beta.
The happy prince sends a ruby for the seamstress to help her get over her poverty so that she could buy food and medicine for her son. The swallow laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble and flew around the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings.
Okay, good. Now, Vanshika, you come. Yes, Vanshika, you tell me this answer.
The condition of seamstress was very... The condition of seamstress was very poor. She was busy in stitching gowns and his son was suffering from fever. So the swallow quietly entered that poor woman's house. She was tired and asleep. So for the hope, the swallow quietly laid the ruby on the table behind woman's thimble. And then the swallow gently flew around the bed so that the boy could feel better and give him cool air with his wings.
Has elaborated this answer in a very nice way. That's really good. Now let's move to question number third. So basically in this answer, what you are supposed to write down, you should tell the reason why he sent a ruby. Because her son was ill and she was not having food. She was providing only river water to her ailing son. She was so dead tired. She was busy in stitching that gown dress for the princess. So when prince saw that condition, he was so moved. He wanted to help that lady. So that's why he sent swallow to give them ruby so that they could purchase food, etc., medicine, etc., for them. Okay. So when swallow went there, so he gave, and it was a heat there because of the son was feeling a lot of, so son was suffering with fever. So that's why he was just kept tossing on his bed. He was not able to sleep properly. So with his flaps, with his wings, he flapped his wings. And with that wings, he gave air to that boy. So when that boy felt that air in that fever, so he felt so soothing. And because of that air, because of that comfort, he went to sleep. Because of fever, he was not able to sleep. But because of that air, he went to sleep and he went into a deep slumber. Okay. So when such kind of incident happened and this story was told by Swallow to Prince. Clear? Now next question we have is, for whom does the prince send the spires and why? For whom? One of the sapphire was sent for playwright who was busy in writing play, and second was sent for little matchstick girl who was selling matchsticks in the market, and her matchsticks fell into the gutter and it got wet. Okay, so who is going to tell me this answer? So I expect this answer from Jashan. Jashan, you tell me this answer. Hurry up, Jashan. You tell me this answer.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning, beta.
Ma'am, I don't know the answer.
I don't know why when I was teaching you this chapter, when I was explaining you this chapter, for last 3-4 days, where were you? Where were you? Tell me, Jashan. You were not in the class. Okay, now Jaskirat Singh, you tell me this answer. Jaskirat Singh Bedi. Jaskirat Singh, you tell me this answer. So I think Jashan and Jaskirat both should be marked absent if they are not telling me the answer. Arzu, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning.
The happy prince sent the spheres for the two people, the young writer across the city and the match girl. The young writer, he was trying to finish a play for the director of the theater. However, he was too cold to write anymore. There was no fire and hunger had made him faint. He sent the sphere to the young playwright so that he could sell it to the jewelry, but firewood and finish his play. The happy prince when saw a match girl who was standing in the stair just below him. She had let her matches fall in the gutter because of which they were all spoiled. The prince knew that her father would beat her if she did not bring home some money. When the swallow slipped the jewelry into the palm of the little girl, she ran home happy and laughing.
Okay, good. Very good. Very nice. Now same answer I expect, Jaskirat. I'm giving you 2 minutes to frame this answer. You have sent me message in chat box that you will take hardly 2 minutes. So I'm giving you 2 minutes to frame this answer. Okay, now Ashmeet Kaur, your answer is ready. Ashmeet Kaur. Ashmeet Kaur, your answer is ready or not? They have come to know that the paper will be in MCQ form. MCQ form means there is no need to study. There is no need to do short questions. Yes, your MCQs will not be straightforward. If you have gone through the text, if you have read the text, only then you will be able to do MCQ. Sometimes MCQs are more difficult than these short questions. Because in short question, you are supposed to give straightaway answer. Okay? But in MCQs, 4 options are given and you will get confused. But if you know the text, if you have gone through the text, only then you will be able to do. Ashmeet, you unmute yourself now. Unmute yourself. Unmute yourself. Don't say that you are not able to do. I don't want to listen to this lame excuse. Everybody was able to unmute themselves. Just simply click on unmute. I have given you permission that you can unmute yourself. Other students were doing. Jaskirat, your answer is ready or not? Ashmeet, I will mark you absent today. I will mark you absent. Okay, Nitish Maini, you tell me this answer. Nitish Maini.
हेलो मैम, आवाज आ रही है?
यस इट इज ऑडिबल, टेल मी.
The happy prince sent a spear to a young girl and a writer. The young writer was trying to finish a play, but he couldn't because he needed money to buy firewood which would keep him warm. Therefore, the prince sent a spear to him so that he could send it to the dweller to buy firewood and finish his play.
Okay. Ashmeet is saying she is not getting option. In this matter, I cannot do anything then. You are grown up, you are a student of 9th class. You should know where are the options of mute and unmute. Nitish has unmuted himself within 1 minute. Okay. Now, where is Jaskirat? His answer is ready or not? He was busy in writing. Jaskirat. Now he has left the class. Jaskirat has left the class. He was typing me that I'm typing the answer. I'm writing the answer. Give me 2 minutes. Okay. Now from offline class, your name is? Jasleen. Okay, Jasleen, you come.
The prince sent spears for two people who were young writer across the city and the poor girl selling the matches who had lost all the matches. He had sent the spear as the young writer want to buy the firewood and he would be able to finish his play. On seeing the spear, the young man felt appreciated and believed that he could finish the play. As the prince knew that if the poor girl would go back home without some money, then his father would beat him. And so the prince sent the swallow to give the little girl the jewel and to have some money and give that to her father.
So in this answer, you are supposed to frame two stories. You have to tell the story of that playwright, that why he was not able to write down a play because it was a chilly winter night. He was not having firewood in his hut. He was feeling so cold. He was not able to write and he got fainted because of severe cold. And second reason, you have to tell about mastic girl. She was busy in selling the mastic and all of a sudden her mastic fell into the gutter. It got wet and they were not working now properly. And she was going to get scolding from her father. So that's why King instructed Swallow to give two these stones from his eyes, one to playwright and second to mastic girl. Okay, so this answer is clear. Now let's move to next question. Jaskirat has come in class or not? Now we have question number 4. What does the swallow see when it flies over the sky, when it flies over the city? What was seen by swallow? Hurry up, frame this answer. What did he see? He saw that rich men, they were enjoying their life. On the other hand, poor, they were dying with hunger, starvation. Okay, they were not having food. Okay, so the swallow was able to see the worst condition of the city. And he was so much moved, he got moved to see such kind of plight of the city. The rich were enjoying their life and on the other hand, poor, they were not able to afford even food and shelter. They had a very hard and miserable life. Clear? So who is going to tell me this answer? What does the swallow see when it flies over the city? So Ashmeet Kaur, you tell me this answer.
The swallow saw all kind of categories of people. He found that the rich were very happy and enjoying their life. He saw that the poor were begging at the streets. He was so sad when he see the worst condition of the city. He also saw a group of children who were very hungry, and he saw the poverty of the city.
Good. Now you were able to unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, firstly, it was not giving me option.
Now it has given you option.
Ma'am, when I raise my hand myself, it is giving me option.
So you have got a great moral from Zoom that you should always raise your hand. Isn't it? Zoom has taught you a very good moral today.
Yes, ma'am.
That if any of the button or any of the function of Zoom is not working, you raise your hand. It will start working. Isn't it? So today we have learned a very great lesson from Zoom that you should always raise your hand in class. So Ashmeet, next time your hand will be raised in class.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, that is good. Good spirit. Now, where is just Kirat? Left the class. I think we should have a garland of flowers with us. Today, Saksham is here with us. Saksham, shall I give you a warm welcome with the garland of flowers? Tell me. You are today in my class. You were roaming in Nainital. Your trip is over now. Saksham.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Very good morning. Show me your face. I just want to see you. That you are same one or you are changed after moving to Nainital. Show me your face. You haven't got ready? Okay. So it is, I think you are attending English class after so many days. What was the reason? Your trip was not over?
Yes, ma'am.
You were on the world trip?
Ma'am, no.
I think you have gone on the tour or world tour?
Ma'am, no.
I thought so. Because you have not been attending my English class for so many days. So I thought you have gone on world tour.
मैम नहीं मैं तो लगा रहा हूँ आपकी क्लास
आई थिंक आई एम कमिटिंग मिस्टेक व्हेन माय आई व्हेन आई यू कैन से मार्क यू एब्सेंट ऑन माय अटेंडेंस रजिस्टर आई एम कमिटिंग दैट एरर आई एम एट आई थिंक आई एम रॉन्ग यू आर राइट सो आर यू रेडी विद योर आंसर
सॉरी मैम मुझे पता नहीं वैसे मैं क्लास पे लगा रहा हूँ
ओके लगा रहे हो फिजिकली और मेंटली Physically or mentally?
Mentally bhi.
Mentally also. Now tell me this answer, then it will be proved that I was wrong and you were right. Tell me this answer.
No, I don't know this answer.
Why don't you know the answer? What is the reason behind? I have already told you this answer. You have to repeat only. You have to add up some text only. It means you are physically here, but mentally you are still in Nainital. I asked you a very simple question, but you are not able to give me answer. So you have kept your laptop and mobiles on, but you are somewhere else. Tell me, shall I talk to your parents today? Okay, tell them to call me in evening. Tell them to call me after 6. Between 6 to 8, they can call me. Okay? They are supposed to talk to me. You are not giving response in class. Now time is over. We will continue this topic tomorrow.